Do you want to build Flutter apps that are more modular and maintainable, and you want to share data between widgets without having to use setState? Then you need to learn about Flutter Provider. Provider is a simple state management library that makes it easy to share data between widgets. In this video, I will show you how to use Provider to build a simple Flutter app. If you're interested in these kind of videos, make sure to subscribe and leave a like. Let's start off with an example. We have a product page where we have an apple and want to add it to a shopping cart, but right now we only have it displayed in the product page and we need to share this information with a shopping cart. And to rebuild the UI, Flutter uses the build method, which is initially called when the widget is initially built or when using setState that we covered in a previous video. And to share the states between widgets, we want to keep the state above the widgets that use it. So right now it's only contained with this single product page view, but we want to keep it above it to share it with the cart view. And that's where the provider package comes into play. First, we have to install it. We can add it to the pub/spec YAML using the command line, or you can use an extension in VS Code to install it. So now we have our cart item, which is basically the product with all the information. Then we have a shopping cart, which contains and exposes a list of the cart item. And this class extends the change notifier. That means the class is encapsulating a state and you can subscribe to this. I will show you how to do it in a second. And you can also see two methods, one for adding and one for removing a cart item, and then a notify listeners, which basically notifies all the subscribers that something has changed. It is basically a observer pattern. So to use the change notifier in the widgets, we need to provide it first. We should do that in the main.start at the root of the application like this. The shopping cart is created here and provided. We also have a context that we could use, but we don't need it right now. And if we have multiple change notifiers, it makes sense to use the multi-provider. And then we need to move the child property outside of the change notifier provider. Now that you can provide the widget, you also want to consume it. One way to do it is to use the provider off, where you can access the provided state without actually subscribing to it. That's perfect for things like add to cart, because you don't need to get notified on changes. You just need to access the state so that you can call the add function. You can do the same in the cart page by getting the list of cart items and then displaying it in the list view. But since you're subscribing to it and fetching the current value, it makes sense to use the consumer widget instead of provider. Here you supply the shopping cart declaratively within the widget tree instead of imperatively defining a variable with the provider. So you have a builder method that supplies some variables. One of them is the actual value of the state, and then the builder method should return the descendant widget tree. So same as with provider, you specify the state, the shopping cart, as a generic attribute. So the consumer knows which state to inject. And then every time the state changes, the builder method is called and you get the value as a parameter. The last parameter, child, can be used for performance optimization. In case you have a descendant widget that does not depend on the state, then you can define it outside of the builder and then make a null check on this child parameter. Now, after running the application again, you can see after adding the apple to the cart 3 times, it moves to the cart and it can also get removed and added again. Now, should you use provider off or consumer? You should use provider if you want to access the state and call a method on it, like on actions, on button clicks, and so on. And use consumer if you want to have the latest value of the state and get notified on state changes, like displaying something in the widget and update the UI when the state changes. Why do we even need all of this? Why do we need a provider package when we can just pass the state down via a parameter to the child widgets? But this is actually not a good idea, because you might end up in parameter. When you extend the app, then you need to pass down the state to more widgets, and you have a lot of parameters that you need to update. And Flutter uses a declarative approach. You don't need to imperatively update something in the view. And state management libraries like Provider allow you to simply inject the state into the view. And that wraps up our exploration of Flutter Provider. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more Flutter content.